Good morning students, welcome to biology class. And then the last class we already discussed about that the permanent tissues, and also we discussed about the meristematic tissues also. The meristematic tissue, and we did one activity also, that is the onion. We are going to kept in the onion in a water. The meristematic cells present in an onion will be increased the root length. That the students, you already observed it, and you people are also did the activity in your home. And you people did the observation table, and you are practically know how that the meristematic stems and tissues are going to be helpful for a plant to increase the length of the roots and increase the length of the stem. That we already discussed. And in the last class, we already discussed about that the permanent tissue also. Yes, right? The permanent tissues, the meristematic tissue is going to be get increase their lifespan, increase their life of the days. It will be turned into a permanent tissue. They take a specific role and the loss of ability to divide the cells as a result, and it will form as a permanent tissue. In the last class we discussed about that because of these permanent tissue only the plants are having the shape, size and the strength. And these permanent tissues are having differentiated into so many cells. We discussed in the last class that there are so many cells. And now today we are going to be observe how we can observe the permanent tissues with the help of stem. We will be see that. Last class we discussed about the activity, how we need to be observed, and what are the types of the permanent tissue. The permanent tissue types are two types. What are the two types? First one, simple permanent tissue, and the second one, complex permanent tissue. Simple permanent tissue and the complex permanent tissue. And in the simple permanent tissue and complex permanent tissue, again there the cells are going to be differentiated. That we will see in the next class. And today's session we are going to be observe the how we can observe the permanent tissue with the help of microscope, and what are the cells are there, how we can be differentiated that the cells from the stem. We will be see with the activity. Yes, now I am going to be perform a activity regarding about the permanent tissue. Yes, aim. Observing the permanent tissue from the stem. This was the aim. And the what are the materials you needed? Materials. Here I am going to be take a table rose. That will be a garden flower. Table rose. Microscope. Blade. Slide, saffron, glycerin, cover slip, water, etc. And some other materials are needed to observe the permanent tissue. And now in the last class, before classes, when we started the session, we already discussed about the microscope. This was the compound microscope. Yes, right, children? Again, look at this. This was the eyepiece. We can see with the help of, with your eye, we can see with the help of these eyepiece lenses. And these are the lenses to observe, to magnify the slide. And this was the base. This was the condenser. This is the coarse adjustment fine adjustment. And this was the mirror to observe, to reflect the rays. Fall it on the mirror, it will absorb to the slide. We can see with that slide by seeing the mirror only. And the condenser is there to observe the lenses, the magnifying lenses. No, condenser is helpful for us. And these already we discussed about in the last classes about the microscope. And now here I took the table rose plant, permanent tissue from any plant. This was the stem of the table rose plant. Think. Yes. And now here I am going to be cut a cross section, transverse section. Cross section means like this. This was the cross section. And transverse section means from top to bottom, like this. Transverse section. Think, children. This was the transverse section. I am cutting the stem. Very thin slices. Very thin slices. This was the transverse section. Okay. And next. And now I am going to be observe the cross section now. Very small slices you should be cutting. Okay. Look at here, these are the small slices of cross section of table rose. Yes, now I kept these on a watch glass. And now I am going to be pour some water. Why I am going to be pour the water on these stem? The stem cells need not to be get dried. It should be wet. Why we need to be observe the cells? That's why it should be wet. Now that the cells will be in a wet condition. Yes, I kept it aside. And now I am going to be take the slide. This was the slide. This was the cover slip. Okay. And now I am going to be take the cotton. Why I need to be clean my slide first? Because all the bacteria, more of the infections will be present on the slide. I am going to be clean the slide with water first and after alcohol. Alcohol will be release the infection out. Yes, now the slide was very cleaned with the help of a knife. I am going to be put this transverse cross section of the stem. Of the stem on the slide. How I put it? Did you observe it? The small dot on the slide? Yes, that was a cross section of a stem. On this slide, I am going to be add saffron. What I am going to be add? Saffron. Two drops of saffron I added. Yes, I added the saffron. After 2 minutes, put a drop of glycerin. After 2 minutes, put a drop of glycerin. After adding the glycerin, let the slide will be dry for 2 minutes. Kept it aside for 2 minutes. Now we should revise some more points. First, what we need to be do? Procedure. What was the first step? We need to be cut the stem into cross section as a small slices, as a small slices. And next, add the saffron to the slices. Dry for 2 minutes. Again, add glycerin and dry it. After drying, we need to be cover the cover slip. Cover with the cover slip. Now, the slide was dried. With the help of glue, we need to be cover the tissue. This was the tissue, no? Cover the tissue with cover slip. Now, you should see the cover slip. Yes, right? Yes. But when we are going to be add the cover slip to the slide of the tissue, you should be very careful. Why? Because if any air bubble will be entered inside that cover slip, that will be not visible your tissue properly. So that be careful. And after adding cover slip, you can kept it under the microscope. With the help of the two cover slips, should be kept it under microscope. And you should be kept these reflector light to light. Why? We need to be observe it, no? And observe it with the help of the eyepiece. And you can adjust your fine course is helpful for your eyesight only. Okay? If you want to observe the outer layer of the tissue, you can use the 10x. And if you want to observe the inside of the tissue, you can be used 40x. And like that, 10x, 20x, 40x, 60x lenses are there. If you want to observe the deep layers of the tissue, you need to be increase the lenses size also. Yes. And now, which structure I observed in this tissue? I observed that yes, I observe parenchyma, second layer is colenchyma, and the third layer is epidermis, and inside I observe it xylem, phloem. First, I observed it, the circle shape of the tissue. And next, I focused to inside the tissue and I observed the parenchyma, colenchyma cells. In the before itself, we discussed the tissue is having, the permanent tissue is having a so many types of differentiated cells. That the differentiated cells are nothing but parenchyma, colenchyma, sclerenchyma, xylem tissues, phloem tissues, and the vascular bundles are there. There are having some more different types of tissues are there in the permanent tissues that we discussed, simple permanent tissue and complex permanent tissue. In the next classes, we are going to be discuss about the simple permanent tissue and complex permanent tissue also. And I observe the cross section like this. And when we see the transverse section, what was the structure of the transverse section? Is there any different parts differentiation is there when you observe cross section, transverse section, and that session we are going to be continued with the next class. Okay, and this was the procedure. When we are going to be perform this activity, you need to be very careful. The slices should be very thin. The slices should be transverse. Why? Because if you will be cut into thick slices, you cannot observe the cells. That's why we need to be cut the very small slices. Because I used the table rows here. You can use any type of stem, plant stem. You can use cross section and transverse section. This is very available for every student. That's why, and you know the flower also. That's why I took this plant for experiment, and I observe the permanent tissue activity. Okay, and if we are having a normal regular school, I think it will be very helpful to you to observe by yourself only in the class. But due to this, we need to be continue like this only. But you people will be read it nicely, and you people will be very hygienic. Don't go to outside and be wear the mask when you will be go outside, and be hygienic by yourself. And today's session is going to be completed, children. Tomorrow session we will be start with the simple permanent tissue. Thank you, students.